fair play, but Argentina will now play Australia, and Poland have to play the world champions, France. So they got through really by the skin of their teeth, didn't they? Because they didn't really seem to do enough, even when they were trailing against Argentina. There they are. They've just got the news as well, so they're happy with that. Lewandowski lives to fight another day and maybe get a second World Cup goal. I wonder how all our Polish community in Ireland were taking that. Delighted for Lewandowski that he gets to have another opportunity. As we were saying at the beginning, this is probably his last World Cup as well. What a poor performance from them, wasn't it, Gee?
I honestly cannot get my head round what I've just seen from Poland. I've never seen a team with so much at stake play so passively, have so little interest in keeping the ball, be so short of energy or ideas or any kind of momentum in attack, and so disinterested in winning the ball back, even when Argentina had it. Like, their coach, the Polish coach in the build-up to this game, said an interesting comment, and I noted it at the time. He said, playing Argentina, you have to prepare for when you concede and to avoid panic when it happens. Right? His players,
that,
absolutely, to the word, gave no response whatsoever to
but
going
they didn't
a
panic.
Goal down. Didn't panic. Didn't seem to be impacted in any way. And there was a stage towards the end of that game where they were a goal in the other game away from being knocked out. Oh, like, what a risky strategy to be so passive and uninterested in the ball and have no impact or no ambition to score and leave it completely in the hands of the Saudi Arabian defenders that they just won't concede a third against Mexico. Baffling.
Any thoughts about Saudi Arabia, actually? I mean, you know, they obviously showed against Mexico again that they can score. They turned over Argentina the first day. I think they've added something special to this World Cup.
Yeah, definitely. And even towards the end of that game, they were wondering, can he get an equaliser and open it all up again? I think we said before this game that every team had a chance of possibly progressing. They've definitely been a team, along with a few others, has been a couple of teams that have really surprised people with the results they've gotten. They've made this group very interesting and helped make it interesting. I think Mexico, as I think Alan touched on it in commentary, they left it a bit late. I think their first two performances in the first two games let them down, and by
their inability
means,
to score goals until tonight let them down.
They seemed to have, I think they said they had two goals disallowed as well. So look, they had opportunities obviously now to try and put that game to bed and try to put themselves in a position to pip Poland, but it didn't seem to go their way. But yeah, what a group this has been.
Saudi Arabia will probably hope to host the World Cup in the future, and Mexico, they'll be host the next time round along with Canada and the United States. So I'm sure they'll be bitterly disappointed to be exiting Qatar at the earliest stage. But what about Argentina? I mean, to be fair, having lost their opening game, Argentina lost their opening game in the 1990 World Cup, went all the way to the World Cup final.
I mean, it's been the perfect recovery from that day one defeat. It's now just a slightly embarrassing footnote to whatever they do in this tournament, because they won the group, so it's a defeat that has cost them nothing. There's been no consequence whatsoever to defeat, which is best case scenario. Ray at one point in commentary tonight said they're starting to look like favourites the way they're playing tonight. And he wondered, why is there such a contrast to how they played tonight compared to the opening day against Saudi Arabia? Because in the opening day, they had an opposition who wanted the ball and who wanted to score and who wanted to prevent them from scoring. Tonight, like, what? I don't know, what's the possession statistics?
No, but the last I saw, we haven't seen the final,
70
but it was
plus.
72 to 28.
72 plus. Like, whatever. Like, they've absolutely stunk the place out tonight. They've offered nothing at all. No personality, no ambition, no fight, no pride, nothing. They've obviously heard the coach's words and said, lads, they're going to score. Try and limit the amount they do score. Don't take a blind bit of notice about trying to score ourselves. Don't mind Robert up front. Leave him up there. If he can create something grand, but let's not get near him in terms of numbers. And even if we go one goal down or two goal down, do nothing.
OK, Argentina and Poland live to fight another day. Despite their particular lack of ambition, it might seem, they got themselves through to the next round as well by something of a fluke, perhaps. But let's look at Argentina in the second half and that early goal that, I suppose, calmed them down and changed the narrative.
I think it did. calm them down. It was a goal that was coming. They were the dominant side in the first half in terms of chances created. And this is very early on in the second half. It's not the cleanest of strikes in McAllister, but it's well worked. Again, not a huge amount of resistance here in the build-up. Molina with the cross, he did really well tonight. He didn't have to show much of it in terms of what he can do as a defender, but he got forward quite well. That's not the cleanest of strike, but it's perfectly placed. The goalkeeper had no chance at all of saving that, so deserved lead.
Yeah, Poland didn't have a shot on target in the entire game. And Argentina like dominated possession and dominated chances as well and got on the score sheet again.
Yeah, and I think as Richie has pointed out a few times already, I think Poland just really didn't put up any sort of resistance in any of them. And this one is a prime example of that. I think they worked it really well. They got a possession of the ball kept. They came out onto the right-hand side. Good luck to whip it in, kept possession. You can see not much pressure from the Polish midfield on top of them. And this time, Fernandez kind of just drags a few players out and pokes it through. And it's a fantastic finish from Alvarez. He gets a little touch off his left foot to set himself. But as I say, there's not much pressing from the Polish side there to come through. And it's brilliant from Fernandez because he does drag the two players out. But it's the finish that is a brilliant finish. You can watch here now.
It had to be good to beat Chesney in his current form.
And look, I think it's because he hits it so quickly as well. Obviously, it's gone to the top corner. He gets a touch on a Chesney, but I think it's that quick touch off his left foot and he fires it before Chesney gets a chance to even set himself. So it is a great finish from Alvarez.
Yeah, and you couldn't believe really how complacent Poland were, because their qualification to the next stage was on a knife edge.
I think they played that second half like a team that knew their outcome was the one that they were always going to get. They knew they didn't have to change anything. They're losing 2-0 at this point, and it's 2-0 in the other game, so everyone on the touchline should know that it's down to yellow cards at this point. So you think, are they going to up the tempo? Are they going to have a bit more ambition? Will they play with any kind of pace? Will anyone in midfield look like they're going to command things? Here they are, player on the ball, teammate pointing to him. Go backwards. Just go backwards. Give it back to the deepest defender again. Don't mind going forward. And then you think, well, if Argentina got the ball, are we going to try and get it off them or prevent them from having things their whole way or all their own way? They do nothing.
To wonder how good is their intelligence on the field at that point. How is the information coming to the players at that stage? We're looking at the table.
It must be.
It's complicated.
So everyone knew the situation then, which is it's a yellow card count. Krychowiak got booked in 78 minutes. They took him off 5 minutes later. So I don't know whether they took him off because one more yellow card and it's a red and then that's costly. But it was like, it's a winning strategy. It's a winning strategy because they're through. So on the one hand, you go, he got it perfect. But for that coach, remember, he was criticised coming into this for being too defence-minded. He rewrote the book tonight on how to be defence-minded. It was amazingly awful.
Let's look at some of the other Argentina chances, though, because undoubtedly they deserved their victory tonight.
Yeah, they dominated the ball all the time. They had so many opportunities. I think Messi really started to pull the strings a little bit more tonight. I think we talked about the lads having to help him out, and they did with the goals, but I think he did start to pull the strings. He seemed to be enjoying it in that second half, probably because, as Richie said, he had so much space and time on the ball at times. But they dominated the whole game, the whole second half particularly. Poland just never looked like threatening. It's a great ball through by Messi, and you're thinking, you have to go across the keeper. He tries to hit at the inside of the keeper and hits the side netting. But as I said, just so many opportunities. Sloppy defending here from Poland, and he could put them right through. And I think Martinez will have to have his work cut out from trying to get back into that starting 11 the next game. And that was a perfect opportunity for him to show what he can offer. And as I said, it just felt like there was opportunity after opportunity for Argentina. Probably to be disappointed he didn't take a few more of them, to be honest. But it was just nothing from Poland in that second half.
The difference a week has made to them. Like, think of the reaction at home and the panic in the dressing room after losing the opening game. And the players have said they started that second game way too anxious. They've said that themselves, and it took the goal for Messi to settle them down. They're now finishing the group, not only as group winners, but I'd imagine a huge amount of confidence. And I'd imagine they think, well, we've answered loads of critics. We've got everything back on track now. The long unbeaten run we had beforehand, the justifiable tag of favourites, we'll now own that again. And the first day, let's forget about that. That's what they'll be telling themselves.
Let's go back to the penalty, though, because it really was a huge moment in the game. I mean, on initial kind of look at it, you know, did you think it was?
Yeah, well, first of all, it was a superbly saved penalty kick, but this was the incident at the time when we saw Messi go down, and VAR asked the referee to come over and have a look at this. So everything that happened after this is the referee's decision. So he makes the call here that what Chesney did here is a foul. And as I said at halftime, there's been an instruction to referees over the last couple of years. If a goalkeeper comes to punch and doesn't contact the ball but contacts the player's head, it's a foul, so it's a penalty. But there is contact there, and I don't think it's certainly not a punch. There's no intention. It's not dangerous or reckless. And I just don't think it's the level of contact which should have resulted in a corner, in a penalty kick. You think of all the amount of contact between players at corner kicks, defending or attacking, whether it's goalkeeper, defender, attacker. That shouldn't be a level of contact that warrants a penalty kick.
OK, well, Chesney will have to be at his very best against world champions France in the next game. England to play Senegal, and France, the world champions, to play Poland. So, guys, when you look at those fixtures now, is it making it any easier to map out who's going to win this World Cup 2022?
I don't know if it's making it any easier to map it out, but I think definitely, obviously early on in the tournament, you always see surprise results. I think we've seen that throughout this group stage so far, but I think the likes of Argentina now starting to really show what we expected from them coming into the tournament. So I think now what we will see is the bigger nations really showing up, and when it comes to the crunch, it'll be them, their turn to show what they really are about.
I showed you my World Cup wall chart earlier and it had Argentina, England in the final, and you didn't believe me.
Well, you're not right yet. I wouldn't go shoot
well,
your
I'm not
mouth
wrong
off.
Yet.
Yeah, wouldn't shoot me your mouth off just yet. I think this is the really interesting part of the thing now, because we spoke tonight. Is it the last game for Messi? Is it the last for Lewandowski? It's those kind of big existential crisis now for each nation going into every game from now on, a bad game and you're out. So it's been really good, like, because we've had surprise results, France getting beaten today, Argentina getting beaten, see what happened to Germany as well. So it's been really good. The football's been really good. Hard to predict though, so I think virtually all my predictions have been incorrect so far.
So as I was saying, Steph, I mean, tonight did we learn that Messi can handle the pressure? Or was that penalty miss going to haunt him into the next one? If they get a penalty again, will he take it?
Oh, definitely. I'm sure he will. I think, and that's actually a point to make as well, because missing that penalty, that could have set them back and they might not have pushed on to get the win. So that's even more important for them. I think for me, when I seen them against Mexico in that second half, I really felt like, as I said, that kind of the weight was off their shoulder and they would come into this game and perform. And as I said, after missing that penalty, you would worry, would they kind of put their heads down? But they still rallied around and got the win. So I think Argentina definitely are looking good now.
The world champions France beaten by Tunisia today. Will that knock their confidence, or did it matter because they were already through?
Again, there was a different set of circumstances. They knew they were already through, so I don't think that's as damaging a defeat as the big defeats of the other one. But I think in relation to Argentina today, I think the way they finished, I think they'll be feeling very, very confident.
Mm. Australia? I mean, they'll be celebrating. And the fact that they beat Denmark, and they were the team that had the courage of their convictions before this World Cup began.
In releasing that video?
Yeah.
Yeah, they did. Again, I don't think the two things are linked. They've done well on the pitch because anything to do with that video. I wouldn't fancy being in their shoes having to play Argentina, but I think they're in territory now where it's beyond what they were expected to do. Maybe it's the what they most hoped they would achieve, but I don't think they're going into that Australia game with any expectation. You asked a moment ago, is Messi dealing with the pressure? Of course he is. He's had pressure on him since he started playing football because he's been the best player on every pitch he's ever been on. So it's not a question of whether he'll deal with the pressure, it's whether collectively Argentina can do enough. From what we saw tonight and what we saw in the last game, I think they should have enough to beat Australia.
I'm glad he's still in the tournament. Are you?
Yeah, definitely. I think most people are. You know, we said before, we don't want to see, particularly in his last tournament, him never playing again in the World Cup. So the longer we can keep Messi in, I think the better for everybody watching.